Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You are welcome in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are the Easter people, and hallelujah is our song. The Lord is no longer in the grave. He is no longer here. He is risen, as he said. You are welcome to day three of our prayer, our ongoing 21 days baptism of prayer. It has been wonderful. I appreciate all the calls, all the WhatsApp messages, and Dina Chiyokonkwo, God bless you, mother. I've not seen you for a while, I understand. God bless you, mama. I appreciate the calls and everything. So today happens to be another wonderful day, because today we are taking authority and we are rebuking the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. It is the spirit of that opposes all your plans. When you are planning to do something, the thing is not working. What is the cause? It is the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. The spirit of opposition, opposing all your plans. Whatever you can imagine as plans that is not working, it is being opposed. A lot of believers does not know this. Anything that opposes your plan, it is a spirit, the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah, opposing you and reproaching you, opposing you and laughing at you, opposing you and ensuring that that plan will never work. The spirit of Sabalat, you are going to see that in Nehemiah chapter 4, 1 to 23. So without wasting much time, we just go straight to our readings and our prayer, because I also have the morning mass today. So quickly we read this is our manual. I appreciate all those who have gotten their own, and the one that we sent to Lagos yesterday and Abuja and Warri. The one in going to Abuja, we arrived today by the grace of God. And the one in Warri is already in Warri, because Warri is not far from here. So I will take the reading from Nehemiah chapter 4, 1 to 23. When Sabalat, listen, oh, this is the spirit that opposes you. When you want to do something, it's not working, you cannot even do it. What is opposing you? You have the mind to do it. You want to do it. You wrote it down that this is what you will do. This is what you want to do, but you cannot do it. This is what you want to do, and it's not falling in place. A lot of people don't know what is wrong. A lot of people don't know what is happening. A lot of people don't know how to go about it. And so, the reading is Nehemiah chapter 4, 1 to 23. 1 to 23, not 1 to 3. So a lot of people don't know what to do. A lot of people don't know how to go about it. A lot of people don't know how to solve it. And unfortunately, a lot of people don't even know what is wrong. How come you have this plan? It is not working. How come you have this plan? It's not falling into place. How come you have this plan? Your plan at the beginning of the year is that this is what you are going to do. Now we are almost at the middle of the year. It's not forthcoming. You have not even done anything yet. Spiritually, what is opposing you? Physically, who is opposing you? That is what we are dealing today. And if you are a wise fellow, you are going to join me to really pray, because until you deal with the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah, you go nowhere. It was the spirit that opposed my ministry when I started early. But you see, I understand the game, and I handled Sabalat and Tobiah. I stood my ground and I rebuked this spirit. And today, by the grace of God, we are not only standing, we are raising structures. So a lot of people don't know what is fighting them. A lot of people don't know how to even go about situations. They don't even know why they are still where they are. why they are being rebuked, resisted, and reproached. It is the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. So I will read quickly. When Sabalat heard that we Jews had begun rebuilding the wall, he became furious and he began to ridicule us. Anybody that is furious that you are making progress, it is the spirit of Sabalat that is at work. Anybody that is not happy that you are rising, it is the spirit of Sabalat that is at work. Anyone that is not happy, not congratulating you of this testimony, don't worry, it is Sabalat and Tobiah. Look at it here. When Sabalat heard that we Jews had begun rebuilding the wall, he became furious and began to ridicule us. In front of his companions and the Samaritan troops, he said, "What do these miserable Jews think they are doing? Do they intend to rebuild the city? Oh, do they think that by offering sacrifices they can finish the work in one day? Do they make building stone out of heap of burnt rubble?" Verse 3, then Tobiah added his own. Tobiah was standing there beside him, and he added, "What kind of wall could they ever build? Even a fox could knock it down." Then look at how Nehemiah responded. Look at how Nehemiah responded. Verse 4, I prayed. Oh, thank you, Jesus. So that is why we are praying today. Prayer is our response to the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. Prayer is our response to the spirit of opposition. Prayer is our response to their reproach. I prayed, "Hear how they make fun of us, O God. Let their ridicule fall on their own head." This is how to pray. Let their ridicule fall on their own head. Let them be robbed of everything they have, and let them be taken as prisoners to a foreign land. Don't forget the evil they have done, and don't forget their sins, for they have insulted us who are building. So we went on rebuilding the wall, and soon it was half its full height, because the people were eager to walk. May God surround you with people that are eager to walk. May God surround you with people that are eager to help you. May God surround you with people that are eager to assist you. Sabalat and Tobiah, verse 7. Sabalat and Tobiah, the people of Arabia, and the people of Arabia, Ammon and Ashdod, heard that we were making progress in rebuilding the wall of Jerusalem. They heard that we were making progress. Hey, they heard that we were making progress. What did they do? They heard that we were making progress in rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem, and that the gap of the wall were being closed, and they became very angry. Watch out, people who are angry of your progress. Watch out on people who are angry that you are making progress, that you are improving, that you are prospering, and they are angry. It is the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. It is the spirit that gets angry when you make progress. It is the spirit that gets angry when you are improving. It is the spirit that gets angry when you are lifted. It is the spirit that gets angry when you are promoted. It is the spirit that gets angry when suddenly there is a change of story in your life. That spirit that gets angry, that gets bitter, that hates you for no just cause, it is the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. Look at it here. They became very angry when they heard that we are making progress in rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem, and that the gaps were being closed. They became very angry. Verse 8. So they all plotted together to come and attack Jerusalem and create confusion. Watch out for people that want to create confusion. They want to create confusion. It is the spirit of intimidation. The spirit of intimidation. verse 9. But we prayed to our God and kept men on guard against them day and night. The people, see, you have to learn how to pray day and night. You have to learn how to pray day and night. That was the secret of Nehemiah. The secret of Nehemiah's beauty and progress was that he was a man of prayer day and night. Day and night. Nehemiah was a man of prayer day and night. Not only day. The people, verse 10, the people of Judah had a song they sang. We grow weak carrying burdens. There is so much rubble to take away. How can we build the wall today? Verse 11. Our enemies thought we would not see them. Hey! I like verse 11. Our enemy thought we would not see them or know what was happening until they were already upon us, killing us and putting an end to our work. But verse 12. But time after time, Jews who were living among our enemies came to warn us of the plans our enemies are making against us. So I armed the people with sword. You see, it is war. You want to build, you got to arm yourself. It is battle. Look at Nehemiah. See, Nehemiah understands warfare. That anything you want to build, you must arm yourself, because your enemy will want to spoil it. Nehemiah is a good example of a man that understands warfare. Look at it here. He says, so I armed the people with sword, with spear, with bows and stationed them by clans behind the wall, wherever it was still unfinished. Verse 14. I saw that the people were worried. I saw that the people were worried. So I said to them and to their leaders and officers, don't be afraid of our enemies. Remember how great and terrifying the Lord is. And fight for your relatives. Oh, come on. What an admonition. Fight. It is a fight. It is a fight. The battle to that promised land, it is a fight. And fight for your relatives, your children, your wives, your homes. And I believe somebody right here this morning, you are here to fight. You are standing in the gap for your family. You are standing in the gap for your brothers. You are standing in the gap for your sisters. You are standing in the gap for your loved ones. It is a fight. Wow. Fight for your relatives, your children, your wives, and your home. Verse 15. Our enemy heard that we had found out what they were plotting, and they realized that God had defeated their plans. Then all of us went back to rebuilding the wall. May God defeat all the plans of your enemies. That is our prayer today. From then on, half of my men walked and half of my men stood guard, wearing coat of armor and armed with spears, shield and bows. And our leaders gave their full support to the people who were rebuilding the wall. Even those who carried building materials walked with one hand and kept a weapon on the other. That is how to build. Walk with one hand and carry weapon on the other hand. That is how to build. If not, your enemy will scatter and spoil what you are building. Verse 18. And everyone who was building kept a sword strapped to their waist. The man who was to sound the alarm on the bugle stayed with me. I told the people and their officers and leaders, the work is spread out over such a distance that we are widely separated from one another on the wall. If you hear the bugle around me, our God will fight for us. So every day from dawn until the star came out at night. Oh, look at that. Every day from dawn, that is from morning, until the stars came out at night, half of us walked on the wall while the other half stood guard with spears. That is how to walk. Day and night. That is how to walk. You don't tell me you don't have time. Look, what is the time here? You don't tell me you don't have time. From morning until the stars will come out in the night, this man we are walking. And he stood guard. Verse 22. During this time, I told the men in charge that they and their helpers had to stay in Jerusalem at night so that we could guard the city at night as well as we walk at daytime. I didn't take off my clothes. Listen. I didn't take off my clothes even at night. Neither did any of my companions, nor the servants, nor my bodyguards. And we all kept our weapon at hand. Oh, may the Lord bless this wonderful reading in our hearts through Christ our Lord. Amen. Wherever you are, okay, Helene. Wherever you are, connect yourself to this prayer right now. Connect yourself. Thank God for this third day, but connect yourself right now and go into prayer. Connect your family, connect your loved ones. Connect your father, connect your mother, connect your loved ones and begin to pray. Take authority over the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. Pray that God will defeat their plans. Marebo Shakalabade, as I pray, oh God, defeat the plans of Sabalat and Tobiah. Defeat their plan. The spirit of Sabalat to oppose, the spirit of Tobiah to rebuke and to reproach. Father, defeat their plans. Father, defeat their plans. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Yes, open your mouth and begin to pray. Father, defeat their plans. The plans of Sabalat and Tobiah. Father, defeat their plans. Oh God, defeat their plans. Connect yourself, connect your loved ones, connect your family members, connect everyone in your house. The spirit of opposition. Who is opposing your progress? Who is opposing your rising? Who is not happy that you are making progress? Who is not happy that the restoration is coming to you? You are rebuilding. It is the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. Open your mouth and begin to pray. May God defeat their plans. The plans of Sabalat and Tobiah. May God defeat their plans. Open your mouth and pray. Father, as I pray this third day of my 21 days baptism of prayer, defeat the plans of Sabalat and Tobiah. Defeat their plans. Open your mouth and pray. Malebosha, libababo, rabadelegede, Lebrahandea, rabakalibadonde. Father, defeat the plans of Sabalat and Tobiah, the spirit that opposes my progress, the spirit that hates me for no just cause, the spirit that is bitter that I am lifted, the spirit that is angry that I am being congratulated, the spirit that is vengeful because I am being celebrated. Father, defeat their plans. Open your mouth and pray. Ligabosa, rabade, legedebo sukarondo, ligabode, makabadea, radea, ligababo sakatea, legebo sutarondo, ligabado sakare, rabade legebo, librahandea, rabakalibabondo, legede, librahande karondo, rabakale, legebababo satalabade. Hear me, there are people that are not happy that you are lifted. There are people that are not happy that you travel to America. There are people that are not happy that your name came out among those that will be promoted. There are people that are not happy that you bought a property. There are people that are not happy that you have started building your house. There are people that are not happy that your business is making progress. There are people that are not happy that you are about to marry. It is the spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. May God defeat their plans. 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 I say, may God defeat their plans. I say, may God defeat their plans. I say, may God defeat their plans. Open your mouth and pray. Connect your family members. Thank you, Jesus. May God defeat their plans. I love this reading, eh? This is the reading for pure warfare. You see how Nehemiah handled all opposition. He marshaled war to war. He carried spear and weapon because that is what the enemy carried. You fold your hand. You can never build anything. I'm telling you now. You will not build one thing. You will not lay foundation. I'm telling you now. If this is your attitude, you better do what Nehemiah did and fight for your family. Look at it here. He said, look, when he encouraged the builders. He said, don't be afraid of our enemies. Remember how great and terrifying the Lord is. And fight for your relatives. Fight for your children. Fight for your wives. Fight for your home. You need to fight for your home. You need to fight for your family. It is a fight. It is a fight. If not, you will not build anything. Let me tell you. Any one of you that is having plan to build, it is a fight. In Nigeria, for example, you want to build, the community people just come. They will come and take all your tools and they want to stop you. They say you have not done this. You think it is ordinary. It is a spiritual. It is spiritual. It is Sabalat at work. It is Sabalat at work. It is a fight. Anybody that will build a big business, it is a fight. Anybody that will build a big, you have to expand your business. You have to have many branches. Hey, you got to do what Nehemiah did, because the spirit of Sabalat will oppose you. You want to build a house in your village? Oh, you better be double ready. Let's take the first prayer point. Thank you, Jesus. My Father and my God, as I pray, let every power opposing my progress be defeated. Open your mouth and pray. Every power opposing my progress be defeated, be defeated, be defeated, be defeated. My Father and my God, that is our first prayer point. Ram. My Father and my God, as I pray, let every power opposing my progress be defeated. Power opposing my progress, power opposing my progress be defeated. Defeated. Power opposing my progress. Power opposing my progress. Power opposing my progress. Hey, your progress is being opposed. You don't know why they are opposing your progress. You don't know why we are still where you are. You don't know these are not your plans, but there are powers opposing your progress. You better pray, my Father, as I pray, let every power opposing my progress be defeated. Power opposing my progress. Power opposing my progress. Power opposing my progress. Power opposing my progress be defeated. The spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah, the spirit of opposition be defeated, be defeated, be defeated, be defeated, be defeated. Powers opposing my progress, power opposing my progress, power opposing my progress by these 21 days baptism of prayer. Father, let that power be defeated. 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 Power opposing my progress, power opposing my progress, power opposing my progress, power opposing my progress be defeated, 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 be defeated. Power opposing my rising, power opposing my lifting, power opposing my turnaround, power opposing my congratulation. As I pray, my Father, let every power opposing my progress be defeated. Let every power opposing the progress of my children be defeated. Let every power opposing my business be defeated. Let every power, physical power, spiritual power, physical power, spiritual power, physical power, spiritual power, let that power be defeated. Let that power be defeated. Let that power be defeated. Open your mouth and fire prayer. Thank you, Jesus. Let every power opposing my progress be defeated. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Makababo Sakali Barondo. God will defeat their plans. Thank you, Abba Father. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. God will defeat their plan. Look at it here. Our enemies heard that we have found out what they were plotting, and they realized that God had defeated their plans. God had defeated their plans. My Father and my God, let us pray. Pray with me. Pray with me. My Father and my God, as I pray, defeat the plans of my enemies. Defeat the plan of Sanballat and Tobiah. Defeat their plans. Defeat their plans. Their plan to attack me. Defeat their plans. Their plan to stop me. Defeat their plan. Their plan to hinder me. Defeat their plan. Defeat every plan of Sanballat and Tobiah. Defeat their plans. Defeat their plans. Father, defeat their plans. Their plan to stop me. Their plan to oppose me. Their plan to hinder me. Their plan to reproach and ridicule me. Father, defeat their plans. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Prayer point number two. Thank you, Holy Ghost. You better pray. A lot of people don't know what is fighting them. A lot of people don't know how to handle their situation. A lot of people are just there. They are there complaining. Handle Sanballat and Tobiah. That reason why that visa have not gone through. Are you sure it is physical? It is spiritual. Stop blaming the embassy. Embassy that did not give you visa is giving other people visa. Embassy that... Thank you, Jesus. Embassy that is not giving other people visa is giving other people visa is denying you. Is it physical? Open your eye. Rebuke Sanballat and Tobiah, the spirit of opposition. Prayer point number two. My Father, as I pray, let the anointing of Nehemiah, let the anointing of Nehemiah, the anointing of building great things cheaply, the anointing of building great things cheaply, fall upon me. Open your mouth and pray. Let the anointing of Nehemiah fall upon me. Anointing for building great things cheaply. Come and look at the project we have at hand. It is the anointing of Nehemiah. My father, as I pray, let the anointing of Nehemiah fall upon me. Let the anointing of Nehemiah, let the anointing of Nehemiah, let the anointing of Nehemiah, anointing for building great things, anointing to build great things cheaply, fall upon me now. Anointing of Nehemiah. I say fall upon me. Anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing to build great things cheaply. Do you know how big the wall of Jerusalem is? Nehemiah built it. Anointing of Nehemiah, my father, fall upon me. Let the anointing of Nehemiah fall upon me. Anointing of Nehemiah to build great things cheaply. Fall upon me now. Fall upon me now. Fall upon me now. Anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing of Nehemiah. Fall upon me. 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 Anointing of Nehemiah. Fall upon me now. Anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing to build great things. Anointing to succeed in doing great things. Anointing to build great business. Anointing to build great projects. Anointing to do great work. Fall upon me. Anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, fall upon me, fall upon me, fall upon me, fall upon me, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, I say fall upon me, fall upon me, fall upon me, open your mouth, begin to pray, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing to build great things cheaply, anointing to build great things cheaply, fall upon me, fall upon me, fall upon me. Anointed of Nehemiah, anointed of Nehemiah, anointed of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, fall upon me now, 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 anointing of Nehemiah, anointing to build great things. I will build great things. I will build great structures. Anointing of Nehemiah, fall upon me now. Anointing of Nehemiah, fall upon me now. Anointing of Nehemiah, fall upon me, fall upon me, fall upon me. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Thank you, Jesus. Do you know how big and how great the wall of Jerusalem is? Nehemiah built it. Anointing of Nehemiah to build great things cheaply. Anointing that attract helpers. Can we quickly pray that? Because the anointing that Nehemiah was able to build the wall because people came to help him. So Nehemiah has the anointing that attract helpers. Can you quickly take that as prayer? My Father, as I pray, anointing of Nehemiah, the anointing that attract helpers, fall upon me, fall upon me, fall upon me, fall upon me. Anointing of Nehemiah, anointing that attract helpers, anointing that attract helpers, fall upon me, fall upon me, fall upon me. Anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing that attract helpers, anointing that attract helpers, helpers that are eager to walk, fall upon me. Anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing that attract helpers, anointing that attract helpers, anointing that attract helpers, fall upon me, 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 fall upon me. Anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing of Nehemiah, anointing that attract helpers, 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 fall upon me. I receive the anointing of Nehemiah. I receive Liga Baba 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 Legebosaka Ribrahandonde Lebrakarondo. I receive the anointing of Nehemiah. I receive the anointing of Nehemiah. I receive the anointing of Nehemiah. Anointing that attract helpers. Anointing that attract helpers. Anointing that attract helpers. Anointing that attract helpers. Fall upon me. Thank you, Jesus. Prayer point number three. Oh my goodness, I am saturated. My spirit is strong now. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Prayer point number three. My Father, as I pray, let the grace to finish what I have started fall upon me. Nehemiah finished. Open your mouth. See, one thing is to start, another thing is to finish. My Father, as I pray, let the grace. Let the grace, let the grace to finish what I have started fall upon me. Let the grace, let the grace, let the grace to finish, the grace to finish what I have started, the grace to finish what I have started, the grace to finish what I have started, let it fall upon me, let it fall upon me, the grace to finish, the grace to finish what I have started, the grace to finish. My Father, as I pray, let the grace to finish what I have started, let the grace to finish, let the grace to finish, let the grace to finish, let the grace to finish what I have started fall upon me. Father, let me finish what I have started. Let me finish what I have started. That pregnancy I am carrying, let me finish by delivering that baby. That pregnancy in my womb, that baby in my womb, let me finish by delivering that child. Anointed to finish what I have started. Fall upon me now. 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 Anointed to finish. Anointed to finish. Anointed to finish. Ligabade. Legebo sukande. Lababo. Rigadababo shata. Legebo rendade. Anointed to finish. Anointed to finish what I have started. Fall upon me. 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 Anointed to finish. Anointed to finish what I have started. Anointed to finish what I have started. fall upon me. The Jeremiah anointing, the Nehemiah anointing to finish what I have started, fall upon me, the Nehemiah anointing to finish what I have started, fall upon me now, open your mouth and pray. The Nehemiah anointing to finish what I have started. Not, do you know that not everybody finish? Oh, and the Bible says it is much more blessed to finish than to begin. The grace to finish well. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. You better let somebody know that Father Alfred is online and we are praying. Nehemiah's anointing. The spirit of Sabalat and Tobiah. Opposing your progress. The Bible says they were angry that we are making progress. What are those who are angry? What are those who are bitter that you are making progress? What are those who are not happy that your wedding card is out? What are those who are not happy that despite all they have done to frustrate you, you are still making progress? Watch out for them. Handle them with this prayer bullets. Prayer point number four. My father, as I pray. Prayer point number four. Are we ready to pray? Are we ready to pray? My Father and my God. See, you cannot build anything great if you don't know how to kick into Nehemiah's anointing. The spirit will fight you. People will come from within you. From within your career. From within your vocation. They will rebuke you. They will fight you. They will speak some kind of word to demoralize you. It is the spirit of intimidation. They will want to intimidate you. How come you are doing this one? How come Father Alfred is doing this one? How come Sister Enobakari Franca is doing this one? How come Rose Osawau is doing this one? How come Flo Aju is doing this one? How come Mata Amadasu? How come Felix Oyegboke? How come John Oyere is doing all this thing? How come? They are bitter. They are bitter. Look, God will defeat their plans. God will defeat their plans. Prayer point number four. My father, as I pray, arise and defend me. Arise and defend me against every spirit of opposition. Because God needs to defend you. God defended Nehemiah. The reason why he rebuked the walls. You see, he rebuked the walls that was in ruins. So you are going to pray, my Father and my God, my Father, as I pray, arise and defend me against every spirit of opposition. Open your mouth and pray. My Father, as I pray, arise and defend me against every spirit of opposition. Arise and defend me, Lord. Against every spirit of opposition. Arise and defend me, Lord. Against every spirit of opposition. Arise and defend me, Lord. Arise and mare babo liga baba baba. Arise and defend me, Lord. Arise and defend me, Lord. Against every spirit of opposition. Arise and defend me, Lord. Arise and defend my children. Arise and defend my house. house. I rise and defend my family. I rise and defend my household against every spirit of opposition. I rise and defend me, Lord, in my place of work. I rise and defend me against every spirit of opposition in my place of work, in my place of work, in my place of work, in my place of work. Arise and defend me. Arise and defend me. Arise and defend me. Arise and defend me. Open your mouth and pray. Arise, O God, and defend me. Arise, O God, and defend me. Arise, O God, and defend me. Arise, O God. Arise, O God, and defend me. Open your mouth and pray. Defend me, Lord, against the spirit of opposition. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. If God does not defend you against this wicked spirit of opposition, oh, come on. There are so many abandoned buildings. People could not build it. Money suddenly stopped flowing in. Handle this one. Look, this is the cure. The spirit of opposition. Who is opposing your money? What is opposing your money? If you go around Benin City and other parts, you are going to see many abandoned buildings. They said suddenly the person died. Suddenly the money stopped coming. Suddenly things stop. Suddenly things are not. Look, there are always excuses why things are not done. There are always excuses why things are the way they are. If you go to the hospital now for a diagnosis, they will diagnose you. If there is something, they will tell you. If there is nothing, they will tell you. But for every ailment, there is always a name. Multiple sclerosis. Name all the names. There's always a name. Rheumatoid arthritis. High blood pressure. Always a name. If you want to handle the spirit of opposition, you don't know why it is not working for you. You don't know why you have not gotten that visa. You don't know why things are not falling in place. You don't know why your relationship is crashing. Come and buy this book now and fight Nehemiah. If I were you, after now, at my quiet time, I will go and replay this video again. I will pray again. Because it is so painful to be opposed. It is so painful to remain in one spot. Let's go. I don't have much time. Prayer point number five. Prayer point number five. My Father and my God. My Father and my God, as I pray, let every resistance to my change of situation be frustrated. Open your mouth and pray. Let every resistance to my change of situation, to my change of story, to my change of story, every resistance to my breakthrough be frustrated. Every resistance to my rising be frustrated. Every resistance to my turnaround be frustrated. Every resistance to my change of story. Every resistance. Who is resisting you? Every resistance. Many of these resistances are spiritual. You better listen to me. Many of these resistances are spiritual. They are spiritual. Who is resisting you? Many of these resistances, they are spiritual. My Father and my God, as I pray, whatever power that is resisting me, be frustrated. Open your mouth and pray. Powers resisting me, powers opposing me, powers stopping me, powers fighting me, angry power, bitter powers, be frustrated. I say, be frustrated. I say, be frustrated. Why is my relationship not working? Power fighting my relationship. Be frustrated. Why is my marriage shaking? Power fighting my marriage. Be frustrated. Why is my business not moving well? Power fighting my business. Be frustrated. Why is my life like this? Power fighting my progress in life. Be frustrated. Be frustrated. Be frustrated. Be frustrated. Be frustrated. Be frustrated. Hey, be frustrated. Power fighting my progress. Be frustrated. Power fighting my lifting. Be frustrated. I say, be frustrated in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, come on. Makabusa Taliba. They began to reproach Sanballat and Tobiah. They began to reproach Nehemiah. Sanballat and Tobiah began to reproach Nehemiah. Look at what Sanballat said. Look at what Sanballat said. He said, verse 2, in front of his companions and the Samaritan troop, he said, what do these miserable Jews think they are doing? What do these miserable Jews think they are doing? Do they intend to rebuild their city? do they think that by offering sacrifice they can finish their work in one day? Can they make beauty stones out of heap of burnt rubble? Then Tobiah added his own. Tobiah was standing there beside him, and he added, what kind of wall could they ever build? What kind of war? What kind of war could they ever build? Even a fox could knock it down. What kind of war could they ever build? Even a fox could knock it down. What kind of war? What kind of war? What kind of war could they ever build? Even a fox could knock it down. Look at it. Even a fox could knock it down. They were reproaching them by their words. That is intimidation. There are some people, there is the kind of word they will speak, you will lose your ground. Their words are so full of venom, when they release it on you, your word cannot work again. Your word cannot grow again. Their mouth, their tongue, venom. The tongue of Sanballat and Tobiah, venomous. Then look at, let us take their prayer point number 6 to handle such tongue. You power opposing, fighting and resisting my, we are taking prayer point number 6. You power opposing, fighting and resisting my progress by words. By words. Look at this. You power opposing, fighting and resisting my progress by words of reproach and aspersions. By words of reproach, accusation and aspersions. By words of reproach, accusations and aspersions, scatter in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. You power opposing and resisting my progress by words of reproach and aspersion. Scatter by fire. Scatter by fire. Scatter by fire. I say scatter by fire. I say scatter. I say scatter. I say scatter. You power opposing my progress. I say scatter. I say scatter. I say scatter. You power opposing my progress. You power opposing my progress. I say scatter. 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 You power opposing my progress by your words of reproach, by your words of accusation, and by your words of aspersions. Hey, aspersions words. Scatter. I say scatter. I say scatter. I say scatter. I say scatter. You power opposing me in my place of work by words of reproach, aspersions, and accusation. I say scatter. 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 You power opposing my progress with words of aspersions, with words of reproach, with words of accusation. Scatter by fire. Scatter by fire. Scatter by fire. Scatter by fire. Open your mouth. Begin to pray. Hey, scatter, scatter, scatter. Scatter by fire. In the name of Jesus. There are people, when they speak, their words is filled with venom, venom, venom. When they speak, when they tell you one word, their words are filled with venom. So you cannot build, you are afraid. By the time they speak, you are afraid. You are afraid. See, you are so afraid. You are afraid to build. You are afraid to start a ministry. You are so afraid. You better do what Nehemiah did. He was a man of prayer. He said, let their own ridicule fall on their head. Let me show you how Nehemiah prayed. Let me show you how Nehemiah prayed. Verse 4. I prayed. Look at it. Look at it. Look at it. Let me show you how Nehemiah prayed. Verse 4. I prayed. Hear how they make fun of us, O God. It is the spirit that makes fun of you when you want to make progress. Why are they making fun of you? To demoralize you, to remove strength from you, to make sure life goes off you, to make sure your enthusiasm die. Nobody can build without enthusiasm. To make sure that your enthusiasm die. So what happened? They will begin to make fun of you. Look at it. I prayed. Hear how they make fun of us, oh God. Let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their aspersions fall on their head. Let their accusation fall on their head. Let their ridicule, let their ridicule, let their ridicule. My Father, as I pray, let the tongue opposing me, let the tongue reproaching me, let the tongue ridiculing me, let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their accusation fall on their head. Let their accusation fall on their head. Let their accusation fall on their head. Let their accusation, let their accusation, let their accusation fall on their head. Fall on their head. Let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their ridicule fall on their head. I say let their ridicule. I say let their ridicule. I say let their ridicule. Let their accusation fall on their head. Let their aspersion fall on their head. Let their word which they have spoken fall on their head. Fall on their head. That tongue reproaching me. That tongue making fun of me. That tongue reproaching me, ridiculing me. Let their ridicule. Let their ridicule. Let their ridicule. Fall on their head. 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 Let their ridicule fall on their head. That tongue that is reproaching me. That tongue that is ridiculing me. Let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their ridicule fall on their head. Let their ridicule. Let their ridicule. Let their ridicule. Fire prayer. This is how to handle Sanballat and Tobiah. It is not, oh, Father Alfred, they are laughing at me. No! I've been teaching you how to pray now. Stop all this baby thing you are doing. Father Alfred, they were not talking. Please pray for me. Stop this nonsense you have been doing. Do you know what it means to take you as my project for 2021? But you have to prove to me. See, you have to prove to me that you are growing in what I am doing here. You have to prove to me. You have to know how to marshal at your prayer. That Father Alfred don't need to stand by you now. But you can enter that your door, that your room, and lock the door and take this kind of book and begin to pray and begin to stand your ground. Then you are growing. Then you are growing. Then you are growing. I want you to grow spiritually. The purpose of this platform is to put fire on your spiritual life. The purpose of this platform is to put fire on your bones. The purpose of this platform is to inject fire into your spirit again, so that all those where you have been tired, you don't know how to pray. No, you know what to do now. Father Alfred is standing by you in the physical, in the spiritual. You know what to do. You know how to pray. You know how to do things. You know how to do it. this is how to handle Sabalat. You think I don't have any work to do? I will just declare 21 days festival of favor, 21 days fasting and prayer. Now 21 days again of baptism of prayer. You think I don't have work to do? It is for your sake and your good. Because many of us are now down. Many of us are just there. We don't know what to do. We don't know what is even happening to us. We think that what we are even facing now is even ordinary. The devil has been reigning. The devil has been fighting. Look, it is time to fight. It is time to fight. Hold the sword in your hand. That is the purpose of this platform. We are not here to come and be making money. Money is the thing, is the least thing that is I'm after here. I am after your spiritual life. I am after your prayer life. I am after your progress. I am after your lifting. I am after your family. I want to hear the testimony, Father Alfred. My story changed. I want to hear the testimony, Father Alfred, of all that came. I got the visa. I want to hear the testimony. I want to hear the testimony. I joined your ministry. Now I am carrying my baby. I want to hear the testimony. I want to hear the testimony. I came to this ministry frustrated, but now look at me. I am building my house. I want to hear your testimony. I want to hear your testimony. Come on, I want to hear your testimony. I want to hear your testimony. That is why I'm here, sacrificing, doing everything. Your story must change. Your story must change. That is why I am here. I am not after all your money or what you go. Of course, we need money for ministry, but that is not the emphasis. The emphasis is your spiritual life. It's your condition. It's your story that must change. It's that marriage that must work. Is that business that must grow? Is that children that must succeed? Your children can be wayward when you belong to this ministry. Your children can be wayward when you are part of this ministry. Your children can be wayward. It is the ministry that so incubates you in prayer so that as a parent, you can't bury your child. Because it's a battle ministry. We are in a platform of battle. It's a battle ministry. It's a ministry that we ensure that you as a father, you as a mother, you will not bury that child. You will not. See, that is the purpose of this platform. So it's a ministry that charge you, charge your spirit and open your eyes. Scales begin to fall off your eyes. It's like scales is falling off your eyes, and you didn't really know what had been happening, but now you know that is the purpose of this ministry. Thank you, Jesus. Prayer point number seven. You better pray this prayer point number seven now. My father, as I pray, give me prosperity, give me progress before the eyes of my enemies who attack me. The more they attack, the more I prosper. Hey! The more they attack, the more I prosper. The more they attack, the more I make progress. My father, as I pray, give me prosperity before the eyes of my enemies. Give me prosperity before the eyes of my enemies who attack me. Give me prosperity. Give me prosperity. Give me prosperity before the eyes of my enemies who attack me. Give me prosperity, Lord. Give me prosperity, Lord, before the eyes of my enemies who attack me. Give me prosperity. Give me progress before the eyes of my enemies who attack me. Before the eyes of Sabalat and Tobiah. Nehemiah was making progress. The wall was coming up. The gap was being closed. And they became furious. Father, my God. My father. As I pray, give me prosperity. Give me prosperity. Give me prosperity before the eyes of my enemies. Give me prosperity. Give me prosperity before their very eyes. Before their very eyes. My story will change. Before their very eyes, I will carry my miracle twins. Before their very eyes, I will carry my miracle triplets. Before their very eyes, my marriage will be blessed. Before their very eyes, I shall be congratulated. Before their very eyes, I shall be congratulated. Before their very eyes, I said, before their very eyes, I will build my house. Before their very eyes, my life will change. Before their very eyes, Father, give me prosperity. Before the eyes of my accusers, give me prosperity. Father, give me prosperity. And that's my progress, and that's my progress, and that's my progress before the eyes of those who accuse me. You better pray. Hey, I prophesy upon your life as your man of God ordained to prophesy like this. I decree and I declare by the power of the Holy Ghost before the eyes of your enemies, my God will announce you higher. My God will lift you higher. My God will give you prosperity before the eyes of those who attack you. My God will give you prosperity. My God will give you blessings before their very eyes. Do you know what happened? Do you know what happened in Mark chapter 2? When they brought the paralytic to Jesus? When they brought the paralytic to Jesus, everywhere was blocked. The door was blocked. The window was blocked. The side doors was blocked. The back doors was blocked. Everywhere was blocked. The men said, oh, we can't access Jesus today. This crowd has blocked everywhere. One of them said, we go nowhere. Let us remove the roof and lower our friend before Jesus. And they removed the kababo saka ligabo sekere. They removed the roof. They removed the roof and lowered their friend. The Bible said, when Jesus saw what they were doing, he said, when Jesus saw their faith of not giving up, when Jesus saw their faith, not the faith of the sick man. He said, when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralyzed man, son, your sins are forgiven. So he said it out, you know, audibly. And the Pharisees, the elders, the chief elders, they heard it. They heard what was said. And they began to speak against Jesus. Listen, they began to speak against Jesus. Who is this man? Why is he always speaking blasphemy? Eh? Who can forgive sin? Only God can forgive sin. Why is he always speaking blasphemy? This man always speaks blasphemy. They were saying that Jesus was always speaking blasphemy. And Jesus said to them, why all these evil thoughts in your heart? Which of this is easier? To say your sins are forgiven, or pick up your mat and walk home? But to prove that, he said, oh, come on, thank you, Jesus. Malibu, ki bababonde. He said, to prove to you that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sin. Then he said to the paralyzed man, he said, pick up your mat and walk home. Do you know the next verse that followed? He said, before their very eyes. Hey, hey! Before their very eyes, the man got up. I prophesy on you, before the eyes of your enemy, you are getting up from sickness. You are getting up from poverty. You are getting up from disappointment. You are getting up from delay. You are getting up from limitation. You are getting up from retrogression. You are getting up from lack. Before the eyes of your enemies, before the eyes of your enemies, I say you are getting up before their eyes. The man got up. Look at you. Hey. Yeah, I don't feel like going, but I have to go very soon because I have mass this morning. A higher prayer realm. Mass, the holy sacrifice of the mass is the highest form of prayer in this life. Okay? Because it deals with not the physical, but spiritual. The body and blood of Jesus being consecrated. That is the high point of the mass. So I'm going to go to mass very soon and offer that again for your intention. To weaken the grip of Sabalat and Tobiah. But I will finish my prayer point. So you have to pray. Give me prosperity before the eyes of my enemies who attack me. Father, give me prosperity. 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 Then go they look, you go they go. Hell! Then go they look, you go they make progress. Then go they look, you go they go. Then go they look, you go they go. Then go they look, you go they go. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. Now, 1 minute. Prayer point number 8. But before we take prayer point number 8, share this video, share this video. Share this video, share this video. Roy Okodegbe, share this video now. Mary Imoru, share this video now. Jennifer, share this video now. Martha Amadasu, Jennifer Ikaine, share this video now. Emudari Collins, share this video. Ogbewi Benny, share this video. Oya. Tessie Arabame, share this video now. Chichi Winifred, share this video now. Oya. 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute. Because people want to get this kind of video. We are not done though. We have 3 more heavy, powerful prayer points to go. If you want to go, you are on your own though. So quickly share this. 1 minute, share this video. I'm waiting for you. This video of yesterday was fair enough, but let this one enter viral. Because we are taking this kingdom by storm. You don't lose anything when you share your video. You don't lose anything at all. So share the video. I am waiting for you. Erica, share the video. How are you doing? All the way from Canada. Father Alfred is waving over you here, Erica. All the way from Canada. God bless you, Erica. You are a blessing. All right, share the video. I'm waiting for you. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, I'll be waiting for you. Tomorrow is another day. Tomorrow is my father, release my mantle. Tomorrow is another day. My father, release my mantle. Tomorrow, I can't wait. Release my mantle. Look at the five. Oh Lord, expose the hidden enemy of my life. Hidden enemy, expose them. Yeah. So, please, have you shared the video now? Let me check. Share. I'm waiting for you. Everybody, you have to share. If you share this video, you cannot tell who you are going to share it, who will not get it and not become part of us. Do you know how many people that we have received here? Oh, I never knew that this kind of prayer was going on. I never knew. Do you know how many people? I never knew. No, please, you have to share the video. All right, let's go. Prayer point number eight. I like this prayer point number eight. Let's go. Prayer point number eight. My father, as I pray, let the plot of confusion and intimidation of Sanballat and Tobiah fall on their head. The plot of confusion, the plot of intimidation of Sanballat and Tobiah. Let it fall on their head. The plot of confusion of Sanballat and Tobiah. Let it fall on their head. The plot of confusion, the plot of intimidation of Sanballat and Tobiah. In order to stop my building, let that plot fall on their head. That was the prayer of Nehemiah. Let the plot of Sanballat, the plot of confusion, the plot of intimidation, let it fall on their head. The plot of confusion, the plot of intimidation of Sanballat and Tobiah. Let it fall on their head. Fire prayer. The plot of confusion and intimidation of Sanballat and Tobiah, it shall fall on their head. Thank you, Jesus. Prayer point number nine. Makabado zegede libaronde. Prayer point number nine. My father and my God. Diamond Rosie, have you shared the page? My father and my God. Prayer point number nine. See, this prayer point number nine is very, very important. See, listen to me. This prayer point number nine that talks about wisdom and strategy is one thing you must learn. How to understand this, how your enemy is strategizing. How they are strategizing. This prayer point number nine is a must for you to learn. Let's go. Prayer point number nine. My father and my God, as I pray, give me wisdom. Give me wisdom to know the strategies of my enemies. Oh, come on, my Father and my God, as I pray, open your mouth and pray. Give me wisdom. Give me to know the strategies of my enemies. To know the plans. Give me wisdom. My Father and my God. My Father and my God. As I pray. My Father and my God. As I pray. As I pray. Give me wisdom. Give me wisdom. My Father and my God. As I pray. As I pray. Give me wisdom. To know the strategies of my enemies. Come on. Give me wisdom. Father, give me wisdom. 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 To know the strategies of my enemies. Give me wisdom. Father, 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 give me wisdom. Wisdom. To know the strategies of my enemies. The secret of Nehemiah's exploit was he knew by wisdom the strategies of his enemies. He knew the wisdom where all the enemies were plotting, Sambalat and Tobiah. He knew their strategies. Where they were trying to intimidate him, he knew their strategies. Where they took arms and weapons, he also took arms and weapons. He knew their strategies. If you know the strategies of your enemies go nowhere. And this platform is a platform that opens you up to know the strategies of your enemies. Hey! Hey! This platform is a platform that opens you up to know the strategies of your enemies. And when you know your enemy's strategies, your enemy goes nowhere. May God give you wisdom. That is prayer point number 9. Give me wisdom. Give me wisdom to know the strategies of my enemies. Are you not going to pray the prayer? Give me wisdom. Give me wisdom. Give me wisdom to know the strategies. To know the strategies of my enemy. The enemy did not just attack your marriage. He put strategies in place. I'm telling you now, the enemy did not just attack your business. There were strategies in place. If you apply your own strategies, you will not even waste your energy. The enemy will back up because strategy against strategies. The higher strategies will triumph. I'm telling you now. So you have to pray for wisdom to know the strategy of your enemies. To know their strategy. Enemy does not just strike, they strategize. They strategize. May God give you wisdom. Thank you, Father. Prayer point number 10. Father Alfred loves you all dearly. Prayer point number 10. Thank you, Jesus. My Father and my God, as I pray, let my progress be a surprise. Let my progress be a surprise. Prayer point number 10. My Father and my God, my Father, as I pray, let my progress be a surprise to my enemies. Open your mouth and pray. Let my progress be a surprise. Are you just looking like that? Let my progress be a surprise to my enemies. Let my progress be a surprise to my enemies. Let my progress be a surprise before their very eyes. Father, announce my progress. Let my progress be a surprise. Open your mouth. That is the last prayer point for today. Let my progress be a surprise. Let my progress be a surprise. My Father and my God. My Father. As I pray, let my progress be a surprise to my enemies. Let my progress, the more they attack, the more they fight, but let my progress be a surprise. Let my progress be a surprise. Let my progress be a surprise. My Father and my God, 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 as I pray, oh God, Liga Babo, Legebo Sakaronde, Libra Handea, Libra Handea, Libra Handea, my Father and my God, Riba Baba Baba Baba, as I pray, let my progress be a surprise to my enemies. They attack me. They believe I cannot make progress, but let my progress be a surprise. 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 A surprise to my enemies. A surprise to my enemies. A surprise to my enemies. Let my progress be a surprise. Let my progress be a surprise. The more they attack, the more I progress. The more they attack, the more I increase. The more they attack, the more I advance. The more they attack, the more my story change, the more they attack. the more my lifting is announced. Thank you, Jesus. Makabi babo sakande legebora babo rabaki baronde. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Abba Father. I have 3 minutes to go. I will use 1 minute to prophesy on somebody. Father Alfred, I have shared the video, I know. But this prophetic word is for somebody that will share this video now. It is my video. It is our video. It is our ministry video. I have shared before, but if you want to share once, this prophecy is for those that will share again now. Ready to go? I prophesy on you in the name of Jesus on this third day. This prophecy is not for everybody. It's for those that will share the video once again now. On this third day of our 21 days baptism of prayer, I prophesy on you before your very eyes. You shall see your Sabala go down. You shall see your Tobiah go down. I prophesy in the name of Jesus. Ah, you shall see your Sabala go down. You shall see your Tobiah go down. You shall see those who accuse you. You shall see those who oppose you. They shall go down. They shall go down. They shall go down. They shall go down before your very eyes. They shall go down in the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Ghost. And let somebody shout, I receive it. Thank you, Jesus. Strong prophetic blessing for somebody. Bola Luko Omodara. Father Alfred, today is my son's birthday. Happy birthday to your son. Great grace and favor upon your son. Testimonies upon your son. Your son will do well. Your son will advance. The life of your son will not be cut short. Amen. I pray for all those who celebrate their birthday today. Great grace and favor upon you. You shall arise and shine because the glory of God is rising upon you on this your birthday. Where are those who joined us today, or those who joined us yesterday, or those who joined us day before yesterday? You are a new member here. You are a new follower here. You just came into our platform. You got the video. Somebody introduced it to you. Show up now. Let me prophesy on you. To those, I have 1 minute more to leave. To those who came in here yesterday, to those who came in here today, you are a new person here, a newcomer on this platform. Let me know now. Type, you say, I am a newcomer. Let me speak a word of blessing. A word of blessing. A word of blessing. Thank you, Jesus. Makabosi Karonde. Are you a new person here? Are you a newcomer here? I want to speak a word over you. Oh. It is well with you in the name of Jesus. Happy birthday to all celebrants. Malibu Sakali Baronde. Aha, 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 aha. I want to speak a word of blessing. Anybody coming in as a new person for the Alfred, I'm a new member. Oh, okay. Omozogi. I'm a new member. God, I just got a new position as a nurse. Please pray for my success. Congratulations on Monzoge and welcome to Father Alfred platform. Platform of fire, platform of prayer, platform of prosperity and the release of results and testimonies. You are welcome on Monzoge to our platform. All those who came in newly, may God bless you. I speak prophetically upon your life. Please go and get ready for tomorrow. my father, release my mantle. Makabadade. Libaro Kalibabonde. Yes, Father Alfred Agbonlaho is the name. And the platform is Catholic Intercessory Prayer Ministry. And to follow, you just follow CIPM with Father Alfred. If you say that on your Facebook, you are able to follow us. Follow CIPN with Father Alfred Agbonlaho. You will follow and you'll be part of us. You will never regret being part of us. Wow. Every day feels new here. The place is special. Hey! Every day feels new here. The place is special. Don't forget that on the we are asking, in case you want to come from Port Harcourt, from Abuja, from Warri, from Lagos, from Cross River, all over Nigeria, for the last day event, please book your signal me now for your hotel reservation. We are going to have your hotel reserved for you. Then we are going to keep your seat wait for you on the 24th evening. You are going to have dinner with Father Alfred, and Father Alfred is going to minister to you one-on-one, prophesy on you, and lay hands on you. You will have a dinner with me. Then on the last day, which is Sunday 25th, we are going to celebrate the mass together, and we are going to have the feast proper, because that day is the feast of our ministry, the feast day of our ministry. That day happened to be Good Shepherd Sunday. Wow. So if you want to be part of us, better let us know, and God will bless you. Clara Azu, oh, you are welcome to our platform. May God bless you. The hotel that you are going to use is very close to the ministry. It is very close to the ministry. It is 5 minutes trek and less than one minute drive. Very close. So Sun Rays Hotel is a very beautiful hotel. So you can walk, and it's very, and security excellent. So if you are coming from Ghana, if you are coming from South Africa, if you are coming from Rwanda, if you are coming from Togo, if you are coming from Cameroon, if you are coming from, just let us know where you are coming from, and you want to come in person, you arrive on Friday, you know, or Saturday, or you arrive. The hotel bill is not much. What is the hotel bill? It's not much. It's not a big deal. So it's not the hotel bill is not big. Oh, sorry, hotel. Okay, Henry Osunobun, just help, do me a favor. Just put the details of Sunray Hotel. You know the distance. Just a little write up. The distance, the place. You know, 3 minutes walk. Beautiful place. You know, and you are going to be blessed. So I am expecting you on the evening of that day. We have on the evening of on the 24th, because I see you as pilgrim. You are coming as pilgrims, you know, to our prayer ground. So you should be well garnished, seasoned. You should be well. You understand now. Agata Onuabo, you are a newcomer. God bless you, Agata. God bless you. God bless you. So on the 24th evening, I will meet with the people that came from other states. If you are coming from outside the country, come with a little flag from your country. De Gracia, are you not coming from Japan? You cannot come from Japan. De Gracia, are you not coming from Japan? You cannot come from Japan. So I will meet with you in the evening. We have dinner. Then I will pray with you. I will lay hands on you. Come on. It's going to be a strong impartation. Then the following day, it will be the mass, 10 o'clock in the morning. Everything will be streamed. We have a stream, or we have a Zoom or a stream. Everything will be available. Okay? Everything will be available. And I tell you, you are going to be blessed. I tell you, you are going to be blessed. Enahoro, say, Father Alfred, I am new here. God bless you, Enahoro. Welcome to our platform. May God bless you. How do we support the ministry from California? Yes, you can pay to our Bank of America or Monzogie. Pay to Bank of America, or you use World Remit. Please get to my WhatsApp. My WhatsApp number on Monzogie, IC Ruwa. If you want to support from California, you can pay to Bank of America or you can use word remit that goes comes straight to me, and I tell you, you will be blessed for doing that. But you can put a message on my WhatsApp and add your name so that I will know that you are the one. If you have my WhatsApp number, if you don't have my WhatsApp number, request for it now, I will give you. My WhatsApp number is everywhere. So it is Sunray Hotel I am going to use for those that will be coming. Omozu Gear is very simple. If you want to, then if you want to give your seed, you want to give your offering, oh, Father Alfred, what you prayed about today is strictly for me. I want to sow into it. Come on, it's open for you. It is a higher anointing. It is a higher blessing. It's a higher anointing. And I tell you, God by God, we bless you. Father Alfred loves you dearly. I need to go for prayer right now. I need to go for mass right now. I'm already almost late. Somebody's asking for WhatsApp number. Quickly take my WhatsApp number. 0803-3820291. I am going away right now. Take my WhatsApp number. 0803-3820291. Take my WhatsApp number again. 0803-3820291. And one more time, take my WhatsApp number. 0803-3820291. Father Alfred loves you. I will see you again tomorrow morning. Stay blessed. You are my project for 2021. It is well with you.